We shall talk about metacarpal bones. The metacarpus consists of 5 metacarpal bones. They are conventionally numbered 1 to 5 from lateral to medial. So the lateral most is below the thumb. So this is the first metacarpal, second, third, fourth and fifth metacarpal bone. Fifth metacarpal is present below the little finger. So each metacarpal is a small long bone which consists of 3 parts, head, shaft and base. So the upper end is the head, the middle is the shaft and the proximal part is the base. So these are the 3 parts of metacarpal bones. Head is the distal end and it is rounded. The shaft extends between the head and the base and it is concave on the palmar aspect and convex on the dorsal aspect. And dorsal surface of the shaft presents a triangular area in its distal part. The base is the proximal end and it is expanded. So that is about the metacarpal bones. So let's see some peculiarities of the first metacarpal bone. The first metacarpal bone, it is the shortest and stoutest. So it is a thicker one which is present below the thumb and it is rotated medially through 90 degrees so that the dorsal surface faces laterally. So here this is the dorsal surface which faces laterally and its base possesses concavo-convex saddle shaped articular surface. So you can see here it is not like other metacarpal, it is concavo-convex. So it makes the saddle joint. So it is a saddle variety of synovial joint. And it articulates with the trapezium to form a saddle joint. So because of the saddle joint, it has wide range of motion when compared to other metacarpal bones. The head is less convex and it is broader than the other metacarpal. It is less convex. And the sesamoid bone glide on the radial and ulnar corners of the head. So on each side you can see the sesamoid bones which glide on the radial and ulnar side of the ulnar corners of the head and produces impressions of gliding. And its base does not articulate with any other metacarpal. It has epiphyses at its proximal end, unlike other metacarpals which have epiphyses only on the distal end. So these are some of the peculiarities of the first metacarpal bone. Let's see about the ossification of these metacarpals. Each metacarpal ossifies by 2 centers. One primary center which appears for the shaft. So for the shaft it appears, that is before birth. So it is the primary center. And one secondary center for the head. Except the first metacarpal, the secondary center appears in its base. Only for the first metacarpal, the secondary center appears for the base. Let us talk about some clinical correlations of these carpal bones. So the first condition is the Bennett's fracture. So Bennett's fracture occurs with it is an oblique fracture of the base of first metacarpal. It is the intra-articular and may be associated with the subluxation or dislocation of metacarpals. So it is near the base of the first metacarpal is the Bennett's fracture. So the next condition is the Boxer's fracture. It is the fracture of the neck of the metacarpal and most commonly involves the neck of the fifth metacarpal. So it happens here at the neck of the fifth metacarpal is the Boxer's fracture.